Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. My name is Christine. Today we are doing a part two of my shot with me. A couple of weeks ago, I did a little online, little shopping haul and everything has come in. So I have some products here. We're gonna do some quick speed reviews. I have some clothing here from Aritzia that we're gonna try on. So this is gonna be a fun little haul video. If you haven't seen the shot with me part one, go ahead and check that out. I kind of take you along with me and show, you know, my thought process as I'm looking through buying things online shopping at Aritzia. That part was probably like my favorite because it just felt like I was online shopping with some friends. Anyways, we have a lot here to talk about. I don't want this to be a super long video, so let's go ahead and dive right in. Okay, so I bought a lot of things from the Sephora sale and it was expensive. Okay, I'm planning to do a full face of Dior very soon, so I have a lot of Dior makeup here. I haven't even tried anything yet because I really wanted it to be like a true first impressions. All of my Dior stuff, I can't be of much use here because like I said, I haven't tried out anything yet. So I'll just quickly go through everything that I picked up. I picked up the Dior Backstage Face and Body Foundation in the shade 3WO and it looks like a pretty good match. Honestly, I got a lot of foundations and I'm pretty impressed with my shade matching skills because shade matching online is just a completely different game, okay? Also, look at my new nails. They're like little matcha swirls, so cute. Anyways, very excited to try out this foundation. I actually love skin tints and I'm excited to try this. I haven't tried the MAC Face and Body only because I've heard some people say that it breaks them out and that scares me. If you have oily acne prone skin and you've tried the MAC Face and Body, let us know your thoughts down below because maybe I'll just pick it up and try it because I've always been curious. The next thing that I picked up is the Dior Forever Skin Concealer. This is also in the shade 3WO, and even though this is the same shade name, it does look a little bit lighter than the foundation, which is great. So I actually used this for the first time yesterday. I only used it one time, and I don't really have any clear thoughts on it yet. Blends out really easily. The coverage was really nice. The color also really matches me. So definitely stay tuned for my full face of Dior to get like my full thoughts and we'll do a wear test and everything like that. But this is a pretty sizable concealer. Like it's the same size as the foundation. Also picked up the Dior Iconic Overcurl Mascara. I'm very excited to try this. This actually was on TikTok because people were prying off this little thing and using it as a ring. I don't even think my fingers are small enough to do that, but I'm very excited to try this mascara. I've heard such good things about Dior mascaras and I've yet to try them. I obviously love Dior, so very excited to try that. Also, somehow managed to order two of the Dior brow pencils, so I need to go take one back, but I've heard really good things about this from Alana Davidson that I watch here on YouTube. She says she loves this brow pencil, so I'm excited to try a very bougie one. I also picked up the face powder, and this actually sold out during the sale, so I actually picked it up right before it did sell out. I got it in the shade 3 Neutral. Looks like a really good shade. The packaging is really, really pretty. I do wish that there is a mirror in here. The blush that I picked up actually does have a mirror, so I haven't even touched it yet, but look how pretty this powder is. I've heard from people that have dry skin that they really, really love it, that it's like traceless on the skin, so I'm curious with my oily skin how I'm gonna like that. And then I also picked up the Dior Rosy Glow Blush. How pretty is that? This actually comes with a mirror. It doesn't look like it because they like replicated the powder on the inside, if that makes sense. I've used this blush once and it is a really, really pretty color. It actually does show up on my skin, which I was worried about when I tried it out, but so far, so good. Packaging is very, very chic. I'm just excited to have all of this luxe makeup like in my makeup bag because I love high-end makeup so much. Also, I'm trying something a little new with my makeup. I tried a new like NARS eyeshadow palette and got sparkle fallout everywhere. And so I covered up with faux freckles and then I decided to do a pop of spring on my lip. So it's a very, very fun makeup look that we have going on today. And then last two Dior things that I picked up are two little lippy products. I feel like I had to try the Lip Glow Color Reviver Balm and I don't know why I picked up this like orangey color. I wish I got like a more like rosy nude, but packaging is very pretty, very excited to try. This lip gloss I have tried out. It's absolutely stunning. I've gotten so many compliments on it. I use this in my full face of cream makeup. This lip gloss is in the shade 12 Rosewood. very up my alley, such good nude, and the formula is like gorgeous. Also, I feel like when I wear that, I'm like too expensive to eat anything because that lip gloss is expensive. Last few things from Sephora that are not Dior. I heard such good things about this Makeup Forever HD Concealer, and I am a concealer ho. Toners and concealers, I love to try. I'm also currently on a brow wax kick, but this concealer, I really, really like it. I got it in the shade 33, and I feel like it's just a little bit too peachy for me, so I might go back and pick up a more yellow tone. I feel like for concealers, I usually like to get two different shades anyways. The shade's not exactly right, but so far, I really, really like it. It blends out really nice, has really good coverage. It has like almost medium to high coverage. I have to try it out a little bit more, just develop like more thoughts on it, so I will let you guys know on that, but so far, so good. I also picked up the ABH Brow Freeze. I actually picked this up before the Sephora sale, but I did get it from Sephora, so I thought I would mention it. I do have a battle of the brow waxes coming soon. I tried out all of the top selling brow waxes. I tried out the ABH one, Patrick Ta, Makeup Revolution, e.l.f., NYX, all of them. I filmed myself putting on each and every single one of them. If you guys have seen my favorite sunscreen roundup, it's gonna be very similar to that video, but trying on all of these brow waxes. So I'm working on it. But this brow freeze is really, really good. If it restocks, you should definitely get it because it's just a very solid brow freeze, and I feel like you do not need a whole lot of products, so this thing is gonna last me a really long time. I'm wearing the Patrick Ta brow wax in my brows today, but I have been reaching for this ABH one a lot. Also picked up the Bite liquid eyeliner. I've been using the mascara like religiously. I really, really love how thickening and volumizing it was. I've heard a lot of good things about this liquid liner, and I always love trying out new liquid liners. So I actually have it on my eyes today. At first, it was hard for me to get used to just because it is kind of like a felt tip, and I haven't used a felt tip situation in a really long time. Once I get used to it, it does help me to achieve a really fine line. It does dry down matte. It's super easy to use, but it is a felt tip, so if you are used to brush tips, it's something to get used to. But once I got the hang of it, I was able to achieve a really good thin line. Like my liner today, I was like, good job. But when I first got it, I was struggling. Okay, it doesn't smudge. It's super black. Really, really like it. Last thing that I picked up from Sephora is these Melt Cream Blush Light. This is in the shade Sandy Cheeks. How pretty is this shade? Oh my gosh. On my hand, it almost looks a little bit more like corally, but when you blend it out, it's more of a like burnt apricot color. I did a little get ready with me when I was in Big Bear using this blush, so really like it. It has a really like thin formula, but really easy to blend out. Good pigment. So far, so good. So I just have to use it a little bit more to see how it compares to all the other cream blushes I have. I feel like I have so many cream blushes in my collection. It's like when I'm getting ready, I can't even decide what I want to use because I have so many. So that's all the stuff that I picked up from Sephora. I also picked up backups of the Sephora Collection Waterproof Eyeliner. That is a very solid, affordable liquid eyeliner if you're looking for something like that. Very, very waterproof too. Next, we have a couple of things from Verse. I thought I picked up a couple more things, but I think that's it. I've been testing out this Day Dissolve Cleansing Balm, and if you guys watched my live with Afterpay, a lot of people said that they really like this, so I've been testing it out. I like it. It just has a lot of fragrance and essential oils. Like when I smell it, it reminds me a lot of Tiger Balm, and like on the ingredients list, it says eucalyptus oil, which is an essential oil, which pretty much doesn't really do anything for your skin except for like make it smell good, and it could possibly be an irritant if you have really sensitive skin, which I do. So I think the scent is a little bit too strong for me, and I would just prefer cleansing balms that don't have as strong of a fragrance. I think I'm gonna pass this along to someone that might like it a little bit more than I will, just because I have so many cleansing balms, I don't need to deal with one that has fragrance, you know? So, Verse is an affordable skincare brand though, and they are clean if that is something that you're looking for. I also picked up the Fix Emergency Eye Mask. I haven't had a chance to try this out yet just because I have so much skincare that I need to try still. It has a really thick, almost like very like goopy, almost like sticky texture. It also has a very strong fragrance, but it feels like it might be very hydrating. So I'll test it out, let you guys know what I think about it. But so far, I don't know how I feel about Averse. I've tried a couple of their stuff and wasn't like in love with anything. I just feel like it's very fragrant, especially for a clean skincare brand. Why do you need to put so much fragrance for? Next, I picked up a couple, actually just this from Ilia. I still picked up the liquid eyeliner to retest. I don't remember how I feel about it, so I have to test that out again. But I picked up some new shades of the Super Serum Skin Tint. I've tried this before in a Battle of the Skin Tints video. I don't know if I like the skin tint. It is a skin tint, but it feels very heavy and it looks very heavy on the skin versus like the Fenty skin tint. Just makes my skin look gorgeous. It looks like my skin, but better. But this one, you can tell that I'm wearing product on my skin. And there's also something weird with like the shades that they have, because these colors oxidize a crazy amount. And so this is the darkest shade that I have. This is the 9.5, and look how light that is. I don't know if you can tell. It's very, 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 very light. It oxidizes, so it does get a couple of shades darker and does eventually match. I still think I could probably go a couple of shades deeper because I am really tan right now. But even on my hand, you can see like it looks very, very goopy. And I think Ilia tried to make this like a skincare product with coverage, but instead it just ended up looking really, really heavy. So I don't know how I feel about this. I feel like I have other skin tints that I like more that aren't as heavy on the skin. But if you want to try skin tint, just get the Fenty one because I think that one is so much better. Next, we have a couple of things from Credo Beauty. They're also like a clean beauty retailer. I picked up this foundation and it's a new brand to me and it's called Exa. So I have two different shades here. I shade matched myself online again and I got the shade 290 Seb and 310 Brandy. And the 290 Seb fits me like perfect. I don't remember how I feel about it. I think I did really, really like it. So you can see it swatched like right here. It's like just a little bit deeper than the Ilia one, but it matches my skin really, really nicely. It has like a very skin-like finish, very medium coverage. I just have to test it out more and see how I like it, but I didn't hate it. For me, whenever I try out like a new makeup or skincare product, especially skincare, I have to try it out for a couple of weeks before I can figure out an opinion on it. So anytime you see an ad on my channel or a review or something like that, know that I've tested it for a couple weeks at least to make sure that I like it, that it gets along with my skin, because integrity is very important to me, okay? And then when I'm testing makeup, I have to use it for a couple of, more than a couple of times, just to know how it reacts with my skin, how it wears, how I like it, and kind of like really develop an opinion on it. If you guys wanna see like seasonal favorites or monthly favorites, let me know, because I do enjoy doing those. And I test out a lot of products and I have a lot of thoughts, okay? Next, we have a couple of things from Westman Atelier. It was funny because I remember saying that this brand was expensive. It's very expensive, but the packaging feels so luxe, but I don't know if you can tell like how small it is. And then when you open it, oh wait, I always do that. Look how small it is. Like, you are not getting a whole lot of product. It's very thin, very short. This is very much a luxury product. It also has like a magnetic situation. And I feel like my mom would really love this. Brandon's mom would really love a product like this because it just feels very, very luxe, very, very high end. So let me just tell you what it is really quick. This is the Westman Atelier Cream Blush. I have this in the shade Chouquette. I almost wanted to get the shade Doodoo just for the sake of having the shade Doodoo. Also, can you see this Ilia skin tint? Look at that color. It's oxidized a little bit, but it's still like so light. And it's like one of the deeper shades that they have in their collection, which is so weird. So it's kind of like a pinky berry situation, kind of muted, but on my cheeks, it actually does blend out really nicely. So it doesn't look quite so like poppy. So there, you can see it blends out and does look like a really pretty berry flush. I really enjoy it so far. It reminds me a lot of like the Ilia cream blushes, but it's a little bit more creamy. Like, as soon as you swatch it, it comes out really, really easily, blends out nicely. It doesn't last a super long amount of time that I remember, but again, these are new products. I have to test them out a little bit more, but I was thoroughly impressed by the packaging. Definitely got me. I believe one of these sticks is like $50. which is a lot of money. Some people are really bothered by the fact that I say dollars. It's just a silly way to say dollars that I picked up from Jackie Aina, and I think it's cute, so let me just live my life, okay? And then I also have the Westman Atelier Cream Bronzer. This one here is in the shade Truffle. This is like their medium bronzer shade. I have swatches all over my hand, so it does look really, really deep right out of the tube, but when you blend it out, it does blend out really, really nicely. I was really impressed when I used this cream bronzer because it just blended out so beautifully, and the tone and the color of it was just really, really nice. So again, very chic packaging. I do appreciate that the bronzer is kind of a different packaging than the cream blush because it makes it really easy for me to differentiate. That is all of the skincare product goop stuff that I picked up during my shot with me. I have a lot of swatches on my hand and some nice clothes from Aritzia that I'm going to show you. So let me just wash my hands really quick. Okay, I'm back. So I only have a couple of things here from Aritzia. All of this stuff is kindly gifted from them. I am so excited. I love spring. I love summer. And I really wanted to branch out and try things that are a little bit different for me. So I have this really cute spring dress. It's white because the only colors that they had were like black, yellow, and white. So I figured white is super versatile. It's very long, and I don't really wear dresses at all, period. And I don't think I even own like a midi dress. So I thought that this would be a fun addition to my closet. I could see myself wearing like a bucket hat with it, some really cute strappy sandals, a bright colored bag. It just would be a really good picnic dress, good for brunches. It's a versatile dress and the material feels really, really nice. This dress was $148. That's expensive for a dress, but it looks very expensive on. Next thing that I got is this shoulder pad tee. How cute is this? It's like I had a fast fashion version of it that I've since then gotten rid of in my closet. I recently uploaded a ton of stuff to my Depop. So if you guys are interested in shopping my closet, I'll go ahead and link it down below, but my Depop is just at Christine Lee's for ease. I'm trying to get rid of everything, so be sure to check that out because I listed a ton of my clothes that I purged from my closet recently on there. But anyways, I feel like these tops are very in right now, very much in style, and there is a little shoulder pad detail, and I could see myself wearing these with some like high-waisted pants, like some jeans. I just feel like this is a very, very minimalistic but kind of statement top, and this gray color goes with so much. I originally wanted more of a like beige tone, but of course it was sold out. Maybe I'll try again once I style it a couple ways, and if I decide I need a new color, I'll revisit. But really, really like it. Super soft material. And then I got a little long sleeve crop top. Super cute. I feel like it is just like a good basic to have whenever, especially now in LA, it's kind of like in the 70s to 80s, but some days it's a little bit cooler. So it's nice to be able to have a top that is like kind of summery feely, but will still keep me warm. It also is ribbed, which is really, really nice. And I just need more crop tops in my closet because I feel like I have a lot of sweaters and long sleeves, and I just need a couple more like spicy tops in my closet, you know? So I like this. I was hoping the crop would be a little bit shorter, but I like it because it makes it very versatile. Last thing from Aritzia. Why did I get this? It's summer. I have so many coats from Seattle in my closet that I haven't been able to wear in the almost three years that I've been here in LA. So I don't know why I added another coat to my closet, but it's really, really cute. And when I finally will have the excuse to wear it, I will gladly do so. This is like a brown, kind of like a brownie nude cream plaid coat. It is so beautiful. It's a little bit long, and Brandon has a lot of really good flannels in his closet. I had a little bit of envy when it was a little bit colder here in LA just because he always looks so stylish. So I wanted to pick up my own flannel, and I like that the colors are very understated because it goes with so much. Something like this, you could wear a hoodie underneath, or you can even throw it on top of like a sweater, a t-shirt, or jeans, and it really helps to dress up and elevate an outfit. And the material actually feels really, really soft. It feels like very expensive wool. I like that it's a little shirt jacket situation because you can make it really casual, but you could also dress it up if you'd like, and it just feels very warm. The colors make me really happy, and I can definitely see myself getting a lot of wear out of this. That is all for today's haul. I had so much fun, first of all, shopping and now seeing everything come in. So I hope you guys enjoyed the quick little speed reviews and try-ons. If you want to see more videos like this, let me know down below what stores I should shop at. You guys know I don't like to support fast fashion, and so Aritzia, I understand, is not a sustainable brand, but to me, it's not fast fashion either, and I feel like I can't give up Aritzia, and if I pick up a few pieces here and there and wear them for a lifetime, that is a sustainable lifestyle for me. And so I'm doing the best that I can, and I encourage you maybe to take one step at a time, maybe stop shopping at Zara, Boohoo, Forever 21, maybe invest in pieces that you keep in your closet longer. Just little things I think can make a really big impact. And for me, I'm just trying to be more intentional with the things that I pick up. I do have an IG story highlight all about fast fashion if you're curious on why I don't want to support it and all of that stuff. I've talked about it so many times here on my channel. I try to thrift a lot here and there, but it is fun to pick up a couple of new fresh pieces every once in a while, you know. So I hope you guys enjoyed this fun little roundup. If you're interested in more like monthly seasonal favorite roundups, let me know. That is all for today's video. I'll go ahead and link everything down below if I can find them, but thanks so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye.